Championship Wrestling, bringing you great wrestling action, sanctioned by the NWA, National Wrestling Alliance.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to World Championship Wrestling and your ringside with the NWA, the Major League of Professional Wrestling. I'm Tony Schiavone, your host. 2 full hours here today of the best in professional wrestling. You saw at the beginning of the program the ring introductions. Well, we have a clip of that great match on television. It went television time limit. It's between Ric Flair and Barry Windham for the World Heavyweight title. First time ever the world title put on the line on television. And we'll take a look at portions of that match right here today. Also with us today, Jimmy the Boogie Boogie Man Vian, Vladimir Pietrov, along with Ivan Koloff, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, members of the Four Horsemen. Speaking of the Four Horsemen, we've been getting tremendous amounts of cards and letters from you fans concerning about Lex Luger and his claim last week that he wanted to be part of the Four Horsemen. Well, Lex Luger is back with us here today. We'll hopefully get a chance to talk with him about that claim. You know, we talked about Ivan Koloff, Vladimir Pietrov. Let's bring him in right now. The Russian assassin, the Russian bear, obviously here to get even, I guess, with Nikita Koloff.
This is right. The superpowers. This Dusty Rhodes and you, Nikita. That is right. You know, Dusty Rhodes, you are nothing more than a troublemaker, a bully boy. You talk about the original outlaw. That is you. Yes, you are the one that is responsible for poisoning Nikita's mind. You, and you will pay for it. Vladimir is the man that's going to put Nikita down. And Dusty Rhodes, if you step up, he will knock you down. I told Vladimir just to leave a little bit for me. Let me come in the ring and slap both Nikita's face. And you, Dusty Rhodes, slap you down. That's where you belong. When we slap you down, it is like slapping all American people's face. They look up to you, American Dream, Nikita. Yes, it's just like if I could reach through the camera right now into your home and grab you by the neck and choke you till there's not a breath of wind left in you. Nikita, you thought there was something when I brought Vladimir here. Well, I got another surprise for you. You remember, we went up and down the road. I used to talk about Big Red Machine. Well, he is coming. Also, it is true for you, Nikita. Russian justice, you are going to be punished.
Ivan Koloff, Vladimir Pietrov, also here today, the Rock and Roll Express, the Legion of Doom, the Road Warriors, Paul Jones, and his World Tag Team Champions, and many others. Let's start off by going to the ring. Randy Barber to begin things, and quickly a series of elbows, and Scrappy McGowan will count the man down. There he is. Oh, the fans love him. Jimmy the Boogie Woogie Man Vian to begin things quickly here on World Championship Wrestling. All the top stars of the NWA are here today, including this man, and good to see you back, Jim Horner.
Thank you, Tony. You know, a lot of things happening in Jim Crockett promotion today, but the one thing that's constantly standing out is the Four Horsemen. And everybody knows exactly what I'm talking about. They're picking their spots. When one man gets in trouble, the other three seem to they look back and they come motion, and they all four come in. Now, they jump myself, they jump Barry Windham, and recently I know that they've jumped Brad Armstrong. Now, we're going to form a little unity of our own, and I guarantee you I'm going to be right in the middle of it because somebody's got to put the end to the horsemen, and I guarantee you we're going to do it.
You know something, baby? Look at this face, baby. What a good-looking dude. You know, Tony, this guy here, he's even better looking than you. You know, me and Jimmy, we're about 30 feet up in the air, baby. And what we're doing is just going around in circle. See, we're in a holding pattern. It's raining. It's sleeting. It's snowing. But in our hearts, in Jimmy and Boogie's heart, it's sunshine. And you see, you know, Tony, today is Grandpa's Day. National Grandpa's Day. So I know you got a grandpa. I know you got a grandpa. And all you people out there got grandpa. My grandpa was born in 1904. He is 93 years old today. What I want to say is happy Grandpa Day to my grandpa and all the grandpas out there. Right here, Timmy, Timmy, me and Timmy, we going now to the airport, and we're going to start, you know what it's called, Sook Leave the airport again.
Okay, Jimmy Vine, let's come back right after this timeout. Now, just a few minutes ago, Tim Horner was out here and talking about the continual jumping of the four horsemen onto people, and he talked about you, Brad, and I was there, and I saw what happened.
Yeah, Tony, you know, something happened to me the other day, the brother, that cost me a heck of a lot, you know. I was out on an interview. They've asked me to come out here and make an interview. Now, Ric Flair had intruded on my interview time. I realized the world heavyweight champion, with all due respect, he did come out there, and I was out there unknowingly behind my back in come the four horsemen, brother, and they did a number on my head. Well, I tell you what. That's never happened to me before. I've seen it happen to Dusty Rhodes. I've seen the horsemen do it to Dusty. I've seen the horsemen do it to Barry Windham now. And they've done it to several other people. Well, I tell you what, it don't happen to an Armstrong but once, Jack. It don't take us but once to learn. But an Armstrong's like a fine watch. It'll take a licking and keep on ticking. And if the four horsemen got anything to say about it, brother, come on out here. Like I said, I can't stand out there and talk to Ric Flair or talk to any of the horsemen word for word on a microphone, but I can get in that wrestling ring and wrestle with them any day of the week, one-on-one, Tony. As long as it's not four-on-one, we do it one-on-one. Armstrongs can handle it.
Okay, Brad, let's all take a look right now at what happened to Brad Armstrong. Here we are with Brad Armstrong, and Brad, good to see you again.
Well, thank you very much, Tony. You know, what you just saw was an awesome force in professional wrestling. The Four Horsemen, a part of the Four Horsemen.
Oh, here's the world champion, Ric Flair.
Mr. Brad Armstrong, nice to see you, but you're on my interview time.
Excuse me,
I've
sir?
I've made arrangements to be out here. This is my interview time. You don't have any place anywhere near the set when I'm out here. People are here to listen to me talk. No, people, you ask for nothing. You have nothing to say.
I was asked to be out here.
Talking about Barry. Off
listen,
the set.
Listen, with all due respect. With all due respect.
Off the set, Ric
Flair,
I told you.
I was asked to be out here for this time. They told me to come out here for this time.
Tony Schiavone. Dusty Rhodes. Nikita Koloff.
I'm sick of your mouth, man. You can talk a whole lot, brother. If you want to get it on, BA is ready. I was brought up in a wrestling family. I can't stand out here and talk word for word with you, but I can get in that wrestling ring and go move for move any day of the week.
Anything with me, Tony Schiavone.
Let's do it right now. You got
Dusty Rhodes.
Right now.
Nikita Koloff, don't get in my face again. You are going to make an ultimate mistake. You are way too far in the youth of your career. All right.
Okay, fans, there you have it. What happened to Brad Armstrong at the hands of the Four Horsemen? And you saw Arn Anderson with that guard buster putting Brad right down on that steel chair. It happens once again. The Horsemen continue to attack people. 4-on-1, 5-on-1, whatever the case may be. Baron Von Raschke, Captain Redneck Dick Murdoch in this event against team of Larry Stevens and Brody Chase. And it's the Baron and Brody Chase to begin things. What a team this has become. The Baron and Dick Murdoch. High backdrop that time. Chase went down hard. Now the Baron. Hip toss. And a stomp right to the back. Tag is made. Larry Stevens a little bit hesitant to go in. Uh-oh. Little intimidation by the Baron right there as it comes right up in the arm. Two very big men, Murdoch and Raschke. Veterans, powerful, many, many wins under their belt. And the caliber of competition there is now in the NWA, tag team-wise, then you got to be at the top, and these two men are. Murdoch with an elbow. You know, the tournament, the tag team tournament coming up in April for the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup, 2 days in Baltimore, April 10th and the 11th. Rashke and Murdoch making strides to become one of the invited 25 as Murdoch goes with a brainbuster down on Larry Stevens. That'll count him out. The winners, the team Baron Von Rashke and Captain Redneck Dick Murdoch here on World Championship Wrestling. Here they are, Captain Redneck Dick Murdoch and Baron Von Rashke.
This is Richtig. Captain Redneck Dick Murdoch and Baron Von Rashke. We're gearing up for the World Cup coming in April to Baltimore. All the best tag teams in the world are starting to gear up. We want to be there. We will be there. Last year in New Orleans at the Superdome, the Road Warriors came out victorious. We want to wish them the best of luck. But we're coming, and we're coming to win the cup, the most prestigious tag team cup in all of wrestling. That's all the people need to know.
You know, Tony, there's a lot of things happening around the world of professional wrestling, and I don't like a lot of things that I fought for. But you know, the one thing that's really on our mind is going to Odessa Wednesday night, Richmond tonight, L.A., and watching in Pittsburgh with Dusty Rhodes and Big Bubba. And then, like Baron said, the cup. And one other little weasel that I hadn't forgot about, Tully Blanchard, along with his manager, J.J. Dillon. I still want some of that 10 grand.
Okay, the Baron and Captain Redneck Dick Murdoch, let's go to the ring. This match, one fall for the world television title, and that sack of money right there, $10,000. Tully Blanchard against Zane Smith. You heard Dick Murdoch say a few words to Blanchard and then walk off. Oh, well, a handshake. And Tully Blanchard once again gets the quick upper hand in this title event. Knee to the back. Slam right to the turnbuckle, and Blanchard again. Member of the Four Horsemen, along with James J. Dillon, and of course J.J. becoming the leader of the Horsemen. And speaking of the Horsemen, there's a look at J.J. with that title belt. Remember, that belt is up in this event, and is always up when Tully wrestles on television. Speaking of wrestling on television, and speaking of the Four Horsemen, we're going to take a look coming back in just a few minutes at the match for the World Heavyweight title, Ric Flair, Barry Windham on TV, and what a tremendous event that was. Tremendous, look at that tremendous forearm by Blanchard. And another one. Uppercuts right to the chin, knocking Smith right to the neck. Adds him up. Already with a slingshot suplex. Blanchard. And again, he gets a win. Tully Blanchard, a quick win over Zane Smith. Well, like we said earlier, a tremendous event. Ric Flair defending the World Heavyweight title on television against this man, Barry Windham. Barry, you're here with me. We all want to take a look at what happened. We joined the match 25 minutes into the match. Ric Flair defending the World Heavyweight title against Barry Windham. An event that was. Ric Flair, Barry Windham, World Heavyweight title. And understandably, when Ric Flair got into the dressing room, he was very happy, relieved that he still had that World Heavyweight title, because that was one tremendous event. Let's take a look and go to Bob Cottle now, who was in the dressing room with Ric Flair and the Four Horsemen right after that match. Okay, Barry, you've heard the comment from Ric Flair. He said you made a mistake. It appears you didn't make any mistake at all. It appears you really have the man's number.
Well, Tony, first of all, you know the world champion is the best wrestler in the whole world. He is the world heavyweight champion. I will not take that away from him. But Ric Flair, your days are numbered. I will tell you, we went the time limit. There were times where if I had been moving a little faster, I could have beat you. So, Ric Flair, you keep it in mind. You might have all the girls outside your locker room, but you're looking at the next world heavyweight champion right here. I'll go the time limit with you anytime, an hour, 90 minutes, 2 hours, and I know you can do it too. But one of these days, I'm going to catch you right in the middle of the ring with a three count, and you're going to be singing the blues just like you thought I was doing. I was happy that we did what we did, and that I was able to go with you. But now I know myself, just like all these people out here, except for a select few, they know that I can beat you, and it's coming very soon.
Okay, Barry Windham. right with us on World Championship Wrestling. What an event. We're coming back with the Four Horsemen and much more. Don't you go away. And we're back with James J. Dillon and two of the Four Horsemen.
You know, it was really great to see Ric Flair once again successfully defend the World Heavyweight Championship. He is the greatest heavyweight champion of all time, and he is the mainstay of the Four Horsemen, if you would, a very elite group. Each and every member is important. Ole and Arn Anderson are tag team wrestling. I don't care who's holding the title at any given point.
Right.
The Andersons are tag team wrestling.
Right.
And when you look at Tully Blanchard, the world television champion, if you really think about it, how many people every night they go out, not only put their reputation on the line, not only put their title on the line, but we're talking about $100 bills. We're talking about $10,000. And I don't care if you're a doctor or a lawyer or what you are, $10,000 is a lot of bucks to put on the line each and every night.
You know, JJ, you said it just exactly that. But you know, you want to get down what a horseman is. You know, a lot of talk going around. Lex Luger wants to be a horseman. This guy wants to be a horseman. JJ's getting flooded in his office with letters of people wanting to be a horseman. Well, there's only four. And you know what? Being a horseman, 24 hours a day, right, Double A? When we wake up, we're a horseman. When we're at the gym, we're a horseman. When we're out at 3 o'clock in the morning with all the pretty ladies, we're a horseman. When we walk in any coliseum around the world, coast to coast, we are the Horsemen, and we make professional wrestling what it is today. That's why we can come out here on national television.
Let's make one point real clear. Lex Luger is a magnificent athlete, and I think it's a great tribute to the Horsemen that he would even go public and make a statement like that. But each and every member of the Four Horsemen, as it exists right now, is an integral part of an elite group, and we're tight, and we're staying together, and we do not plan to expand at this time.
Okay. Those words from James J. Dillon and members of the Four Horsemen. Let's go to the ring with Lex Luger. Okay, fans, there he is on your right. Lex Luger against Randy Mulkey, and what a magnificent athlete this man is. Cast an eye over here towards James J. Dillon, who is still standing here watching the man. Going up against Randy Mulkey. He has been like a brick wall, absolutely. No budging. Him at all. No hurting the man. He said it was a complete package, and there's no denying that. Look at this. Luger takes him down with an arm. Scrappy McGowan calling for the break. Luger gives a break. And when we say this is the major leagues, you look at Lex Luger, look at all the top athletes we have, and you know why. Luger picks him up, tosses him down, and quickly on top of him once again.
One, two, three.
Luger gives a break again. Mulkey tried to go to the right hand. Lex Luger's big, powerful right hand to the foot. And they're up. Oh, vicious elbow right in the chest. Scoop. Power slam. Luger picks him up. And now, that backbreaker. Notice as Mulkey has counted out the physique, the muscles, the man, Lex Luger. Well, there's James J. Dillon up on the apron of the ring. And like Smoother is here, what exactly was going on with James J. Dillon up there?
Well, it's no one's business but mine and his. You know, it's been a hectic week for me. Since my national debut, things have been on fire in the wrestling world. My phone has been ringing off the hook. Movie producers, television producers, advertisers from the Big Apple to L.A. and all points in between. Everybody wants a piece of Lex Luger. I'm the hottest commodity in professional sports today. Now, you know, there's a lot of controversy, it seems, surrounding my announcement that I'm going to become a horseman. But you see, everybody says, Lex, you're already one of the highest paid athletes in sports. You're already successful, but there's always that next step up. Complacency is a word that's not in my vocabulary. I always want a little bit more. That competitive edge, and they are the elite. They're at the pinnacle, the summit of professional wrestling. That's what the horse is all about. I like the way their financial statements look, and I like the way their lifestyle looks. That's what I want to be a part of, and that's a horseman.
Okay, Lex Luger here with us once again, and what a tremendous win it was for him right here on television. And then the whisper by James J. Okay, Lex.
You know what,
Barry Windham back out.
Now, Luger, I realize you're a very busy man. You've got everybody in the world calling you, but I tell you, I'm just trying to help you. You're making the biggest mistake of your life. You know, you don't return anybody's calls. I've left messages on your recorder all week, but like you said, you got the phones ringing off the hook. Listen, you do not want to be a horseman.
You know, Barry,
you have no idea what's going on.
Third time you walked out here during my one interviews. It's getting me very rude. But I'm going to let it slide this time because we've been friends. You understand that? Well, let me tell you, you come out here again, I'm not going to let it slide next time, all right? Just beware of that.
I tell you what, you're making the biggest mistake you'd ever make, but I will not come out here on your interview time anymore. But I tell you what, if you want to be a horseman, you'll look across that ring and you'll see me standing there.
You know, someday, Barry Windham's going to grow up, find out what financial security and obligations are. He's going to find there's more to life, Barry Windham, than blue jeans, tank tops, and sports, paying your car payments. You'll realize someday that I'm right and want to be a horseman.
Okay, Lex Luger fans, don't you dare go away. More action right after this timeout. Here they are, fans, as we promised, the Legion of Doom with Precious Paul entering the Road Warriors.
You know something, Tony Giovanni? In the past weeks out here in the Superstation, the Warriors have been out there issuing challenges to people. And now why hasn't anybody failed to accept a stinking challenge that the Warriors offer? You got the four horsemen, four great athletes. A couple of them are world champions. One world champion, one world TV champion. Anytime that two of you, three of you, or all four of you maybe want to take on my partner and Dusty Rhodes and a six-man, or you want to take on Nikita Koloff, Dusty Rhodes, and the Road Warriors, if you think you're man enough, come on and do it. You know, Tony Schiavone, a lot of people out here got big mouths. You got Rick Rude, Manny Fernandez calling himself the Legion of Destruction. The Legion of Doom, boys, has been around a long time. And remember, we're the guys that say what we're going to do. Then we do it. So in Richmond, Virginia, you're going to find out what we're all about. And tonight, Washington, D.C., Night of the Skywalkers, Midnight Express, you're going to take a fly, boys. Tell them, Hawk.
Oh, Tony Schiavone, there's sure a lot of tough guys in the NWA, or a lot of so-called tough guys, because there ain't one of them out there that ever beat us, and we've beaten all of them. Now I see Lex Luger. Yeah, he's a big cat. He looks good. But he's out here, and he's concerned about financial security. Lex Luger and any other wrestler that's worried about financial security, let me make a suggestion to you. Don't ever, ever get in the ring with us. Because when we're done, you won't need to worry about financial security. You won't need to worry about anything but a pine box. And 6 feet of earth, pal. And I'll tell you something else. I gotta get back to Slug City. Cause everywhere we go, it's Slug City. Cause we talk, but we back it up. And you're all slugs. Everyone we wrestle's a slug. Slug City, we'll be slugging slugs the rest of our lives. And that you can take to the bank and get some interest.
Yeah. Big night tonight for the Road Warriors in Richmond and Washington, D.C. Paul Ellery. Come here 1 second before you walk off. On behalf of Jim Crockett Promotions and Turner Home Entertainment, I'd like to be the first to present you with a commemorative copy of Starrcade 86, the Skywalker video. It's now available through TV offers right here on television. All the fans are going to own this. I know it was a big night for you and the Road Warriors. There's your commemorative copy. Congratulations on a big night.
Well, thank you, Tony. This was indeed a big night for the Legion of Doom. This is the one that has Jimmy Cornette flying from 25 feet up, 25 feet down. Well, this is a collector's item here. Not only that, but you got Ric Flair against Nikita, Dusty against Tully, the Rock and Roll against the Andersons, and the Legion of Doom doing what they did best, Now it just goes to prove that you never did get the best of us, Jimmy Cornette. You only got the worst, and I got the first copy. Thank you, Tony. Thank you very much.
Yes, sir. Paul Ellering and the Road Warriors. Ready with more action. Let's go back to the ring. Brad Armstrong, Gary Royal, and before they really get underway, let's take a brief timeout. Don't you go away. Back we are, fans. Good to have you with us. Our second hour of World Championship Wrestling. I'm Tony Schiavone, and in the ring, Brad Armstrong, Gary Royal, what has turned out to be a great wrestling match so far. And what a day we've had so far. A look at what the Horseman did to Barry, or to Brad Armstrong, actually, and then a look at Barry Windham and Ric Flair in a title match on television. Armstrong over the top to the ropes and a roll up. And Armstrong right back up on top of him. Also, a look at Lex Luger and his desire to be a member of the Four Horsemen once again. Jimmy Vaiana coming up in this hour. The Rock and Roll Express, the Superpowers, Dusty and Nikita, Superstar Bill Dundee, Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, the World Tag Team Champions, along with Paul Jones, Ivan Koloff, Vladimir Pietrov, Jim Cornette and his Midnight Express, Arn Anderson, and many of them. Up with the arm, Brad Armstrong. As you see the pain on the face of Gary Royal. Still the pressure. Armstrong back to the ropes. Royal pushes him off. He missed with that clothesline. And Brad Armstrong in a flying body press. Got a one count. The key to the success of Brad Armstrong is quickness, speed, endurance, and the fact that once he gets on you, he doesn't let up at all. Notice after that flying body press, how when Royal was up, Armstrong met him eyeball to eyeball. On to the headline. Good look at Brad, who, you know, as he wrestles, thinks about what the Horseman did. Especially Arn Anderson had him up there with that gourd buster on the chair. It's just good to see Brad back into the ring after that happened. There's a forearm shot to the midsection and right to the side of the head. Gary Royal once again. And Armstrong counters his own self with that big forearm. Shoots him across. High dropkick. Royal's in the ropes. Brad doesn't let up. A good hip toss.
Come on, Brad, get over with.
Royal trying to figure a way to get out of this, but Armstrong has hooked onto that arm. Want to say hello to his father, Bob Armstrong, who I understand we'll be seeing a lot more of in the near future. A miss with a right hand. Good takeover. Armstrong back up with the arm again. We're at the studios of WTBS in Atlanta, Georgia, the Superstation. Good to have you with us. All of our fans all over the country, I know, will want to be a part of World Championship Wrestling whenever it comes your way. We have some great fans all around the world. Hello to Angela Harris, who's 26 years old today. Longtime fan of World Championship Wrestling. Royal slams Armstrong in. And another slam. Brad reeling now from those slams of the turnbuckle, and Gary Royal seemingly in control right now. The fans behind Armstrong as Royal only gets a one count. Boy, Royal in command right now, but you can tell, just take a good look at Brad, that he is thinking, gathering, there's a good look at Brad, gathering some momentum maybe to come back, plotting what he's going to do, how he's going to get out of it. The mark of a great wrestler. There you go, right back where they are. And the fans still chanting for Brad Armstrong as he continues to work on that arm. Well, you know of his problems with Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin and
superstar Bill Dundee, and now the Horseman. So Armstrong really has his work cut out for him, with people wanting to get him, I guess, or in the ring, or prevent him from getting into the ring. That was obvious with the Horseman ganging up on him. They wanted to put him out. All the way across, Armstrong bounced off of that. Royal miss, and that gives Armstrong an opportunity for that neck breaker. Brad Armstrong. Your winner. Fans, you may hear in the background the chant of rock and roll for only one team, the Rock and Roll Express.
You know, Tony, I like to talk about Rick Rude, Manny Fernandez, and Paul Jones. See, right now, they're on top of the world because they are the NWA World Tag Team Champions. But see, here's something. Let me tell you something, Paul Jones. Sooner or later, your boys are going to make a mistake. My brother and I, we're going to capitalize on it because, see, Tony, we got one thing in mind. That's regaining the NWA World Tag Team titles.
That's right, Tony. You know, no matter what kind of business anybody or any profession they got, there always comes a time where they take all the pressure. They have to put all of it on them. But you see, Manny Fernandez, Rick Rude, and Paul Jones, the pressure's on you, and you can't handle it. You see, baby, all the matches we had with you, when the match is over, you're running back to the dressing room with your tails between your legs. But you know, baby, the rock and roll fell out a long time ago. If you want to hang around the big dogs, you got to get up off the porch. You see, baby, because if you want to be the champion, if you want to be a big star, it's a long, long, hard ride. And speaking of a long, hard ride, no matter if it's rock and roll, no matter if it's country music, the number one man of Jim Crockett Promotion and the number one man of the Rock and Roll Express is right here today. I'd like to bring him out here right now, Mr. David Allen Cole, Tony, because he's playing right here in the lap.
Okay, yeah. Good to see you, David.
Hey, how you doing?
All right, David.
I want to say a couple things while I'm out here, and one of the things that I want to say is I'm expecting you guys to win them belts back and bring them back home to us. And I especially want to say something to Ric Flair while I'm here today. And I know that you won the championship back from my partner, Dusty Rhodes. And I know you've been resting easy since Magnum T.A. had his accident. And I know you heard that he'd never walk again. But I just want you to know that he took his first step about 4 days ago, buddy. And he's coming your way. Yeah, I'm playing here tonight at the center stage. So y'all come out and rock and roll with the David Allen Coe Band.
Tony, we have to go and can't be late because Bill Roberts got two lovely ladies that just won't wait.
Okay, David Allen Coe, good to see him. And, of course, as always, a Rock and Roll Express. More action with the superpowers and much more. Don't you dare go away. Okay, fans, back with you on World Championship Wrestling, a hot show today. Let's bring in right now the superpowers, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, Nikita Koloff, and we've heard earlier from Ivan Koloff and Vladimir Pietro.
Well, you know, I really tired, Tony. I tired, first of all, of a Four Horsemen. You see, I seen Four Horsemen attack Dusty Rhodes. I have seen the Horsemen attack Barry Windham, Brad Armstrong, the Road Warrior right here, and they even attack Nikita Koloff. Well, Four Horsemen is all going to come to an end. Maybe not all at one time, but it's going to come to an end. Luger, maybe you should listen to your friend Barry Windham. You're making a big mistake. And Vladimir Pietrov, you and I have been around in the past. Many tough competition. But not tough competition, like right here. You better talk to Ivan Koloff. You see, you and Ivan Koloff are in for the fight of your life, Vladimir.
You know what it really boiled down to is Ivan Koloff brought Pietrov to this country for Nikita Koloff. He said he's gonna come with mass destruction. He said Pietrov is the strongest single athlete ever to come out of Russia. I know for a fact, brother, I'm standing next to the man, brother. Know what country you're from, Africa, Russia, wherever it is, Nikita Koloff has become a supreme power and most of all, a friend of Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream.
He has chose freedom. He lives in this country. He wrestles in this country, and he is the premier athlete to ever step foot on this soil from a foreign country. The superpowers form the greatest power in wrestling right now. So Pietrov and Ivan Koloff, they're going to get their chance in the Omni February the 1st to see what they came for, whatever they were sent for, you understand? Me and Nikita Koloff back down from no man. He has no law. He has no rule. He has the Russian sickle, and Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, has the bionic elbow. You know, just the other night, me and Nikita was on an airplane, our private plane, flying with a good friend of ours, Little Richard. And Little Richard, I say, how do you get out of what you're doing, Richard? What'd you get doing? Little Richard said, Dusty say, I was washing dishes at the Greyhound bus station in Macon, Georgia. I did Tutti Frutti, good golly, Miss Molly, and the Lord bless my soul. And I had to get out of there, and that's what we're going to do now. If they want us, they got to come get us, because we ain't hard to find. DAC, my main man here today, I'm going to go back one and have one and sing one with you.
See you tonight in Richmond, Ric Flair.
Okay. The Rock and Roll Express against David Isley and Eddie Roberts. Isley in first against Robert Gibson. Still without the World Tag Team belts, held by Ravishing Rick Rude of the Raging Bull, along with manager Paul Jones. But fans believe in their hearts that it won't be too long before these two men are back on top again. As far as titles are concerned, Isley waited, and Gibson with a hard slam down across the chest with that knee. Back around Starcade time, and right afterwards, both men, Morton and Gibson, suffering many injuries that slowed them down. But now they're back, full gear now, looking better than ever, with an official fan club that they are very pleased about. The number of fans are becoming members. Roberts with a slam, but he missed the elbow. And Morton right on top of Roberts with a slam of his own. Ricky Morton. Give him Scrappy McGowan a high five there. Gibson, that's a one count. Eddie Roberts holding out of the headlock. Good hip toss by Gibson. Intensity is right there with Ricky and Robert at all times. Hi, back with that one. Roberts moves him right in. Good takedown. Right in the midsection with the knee, and Gibson quickly got out of the corner. His eyes lit up. We're talking about teamwork at its best. Quickness at its best. You see the fans just looking on at Morton and Gibson. Now Ricky Morton in. When they first arrived on the scene at the NWA, so take a look at Ricky having something to say to Eddie Roberts. We're talking about the summer of 85, and on the scene, very first match, winning the NWA World Tag Team title. And since that time, fans have just weren't accustomed to the fact that, in a way, when you think about the Rock and Roll Express World Tag Team title, means one and the same, synonymous. But now, Ravishing Rick Rude and the Raging Bull. What a team this is. Martin, his hair was pulled. And that really got his dander up. Both men roll out. Knocked down Eddie Roberts. And now both are prepared for the double drop kick. The Rock and Roll Express. Okay, fans, gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, Precious, and the Central States Heavyweight Champion Superstar Bill Dundee.
Tony Schiavone. Jimmy.
Go for it, baby.
You can't take nothing off the Rock and Roll. They just won, right, with a double drop kick. They're great, but they weren't wrestling the gorgeous one and the superstar. Now I got some news that's going to shock the rest of the world. I'm telling you, baby, he's on his way back. A couple of weeks ago, I told you he went, right? And when you go somewhere, you gotta come back. And the Barbarian's on his way back. And since he's been gone, I don't want the Central States title, right?
Yeah, that's right.
I'm
yeah.
going all over the Central States, baby. I'm going to where the superstar. I'm telling you, they've been writing cards and letters and they've been saying we're needing some good wrestlers all over the world. And we especially need them in Nashville. And we especially need them in Memphis and Louisville and Evansville and Lexington, Kentucky. Well, girls and boys, your dreams have been answered because Jimmy Crockett Promotions has bought a great big jet and he's going to fly every superstar there is.
Another
to
jet.
All the to another one.
He bought another
40, 50, 60 people. And we're going to climb on it. And we're going to fly it all over the place. We're going to go to Nashville. We're going to go to Memphis, Louisville, Lexington, Kentucky. And I'm so excited, baby, because I was born here, you know. Brother, I cut my teeth there. That's what I learned to wrestle. And I was coming home, folks. You want the best, you're getting the best. And talking about the best, the gorgeous one and precious.
Say oh, they've had to tie me up in the back, ladies and gentlemen. They've had to tie gorgeous Jimmy up in the back because let me tell you something. Many and many times in the past hour and 20 minutes, I've been wanting to come out here and smack somebody, Squeeze. I didn't know if I wanted to smack Dusty Rhodes, or I didn't want to smack Barry Windham, or maybe I want to come out here and smack the Rock and Roll Express at the same time. But the fact is this, 1987 is going to be a banner year, and 88 and 89 and 90 and 91, come to think about it, because I'm getting better looking every day, and there's nobody here to fight me, but that's okay. Don't get bored, ladies and gentlemen, because I'm looking around, and I'm going to find somebody. Now, I'm going to be busy because I'm going to Richmond, and I'm going to Washington, D.C., with my main man and the prettiest girl in the world. And by the way, have I told you lately that you got some beautiful lips? But the fact is this, it almost brings tears to my eyes when I think that we can't be at Center Stage in Atlanta, Georgia, to watch David Allen Coe tonight. I almost want to drop to my knees and cry, but I want you to know, David, that Billy and Squeeze and me are going to be thinking of you. And give a little kiss to Tony on the cheek, just a little one. It's your lucky day, because I think you're not a bad guy after all.
Would you like to make all America jealous? Just yeah. Kiss Squeeze. Look at this, America. I know every man out here wants to do this, but you can't, because he belongs to gorgeous Jimmy. We'll see you, Daddy.
Beautiful. Man.
Okay, gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, Precious, and superstar Bill Dundee. More action right after this timeout. Tag Team Champions, Ravishing Rick Rude and the Raging Bull, along with Paul Jones, the manager, the man who's, you know, Paul Jones is has had a lot of men in his stable, so to speak. But this, without a doubt, the most successful team. And they really surprised the wrestling world when they won the titles. And I guess they're surprising people even more that they're holding on to the titles for as long as they have. The Raging Bull in there against Chance McQuaid. Tommy Angel, the man outside. There's a look at Paul Jones looking on in approval, the mastermind. And you know, Paul, not only a mastermind when it comes to in the ring, because the man is a former U.S. heavyweight champion, a former world tag team champion on many occasions himself, but as far as financial aspects of wrestling, investments, the man, Paul Jones, has done it all and can do it all. And now he's got two men that can do it all also. As Rick Rude. There's a look at the back of Paul Jones. The very dapper Paul Jones. As the Bull is in. Jones will be the first to credit the tag teams in the NWA. Because, hey, there are some great ones. Even though these two men are on top, we have seen the Rock and Roll Express in this program. How about the Legion of Doom, the Road Warriors? For many years, they were Tag Team of the Year, Rock and Roll Express Tag Team of the Year this past year. So the competition's there. The fact that the Bull and Ravishing Rick Rude are on top says a lot for not only Paul Jones, but for this team. Right now, at the height of tag team competition. Cash McQuaid got a double elbow that time. Ravishing Rick Rude is in. And it didn't take this team long either. You know, Rick Rude just arrived to the NWA after being a regional champion. Part of the country. Oh, there was a big clothesline out of the ropes. And he teamed up with the Bull, and what, a month later, 3 weeks later, this team, World Tag Team Champion. How about it, Angel? Give it up. Angel back to the ropes. High drop. Bull right on top of him again. Bull looked over to his partner that time. Shoots him across again. Into the midsection. Angel really hurt right now. And now both men. Double knee. Rude Connie. And the Rude Awakening. What an awesome move that is. What an awesome team. There they are, the World Tag Team Champions, along with Paul Jones. And the expertise of this man, a former tag team champion himself, and then these two great athletes.
Let me tell you something. Everybody said rock and roll, they holler rock and roll this. Well, the real R&R standing right here. You know, let me tell you something right now. These men don't have a big fan club, and they don't sing. The only time they do sing is on the way to the bank. And everybody told me, Paul Jones, when I formed this great group, they told me they're only going to take your money. They're a flash in the pan. They won't last. Well, here they are. They're still your world champions, and they're going to stay your world champions. Rock and Roll Express, you have speed. You were champions before, but never again. And the guys with the big arms, the Road Warriors, well, you bring it on, because I'll show you why they are champions.
That's right, Paul. You hit the nail on the head. The Rock and Roll Express, they're kind of cute. They got speed. They got teamwork. Ricky Morton, he has a voice like a songbird.
But you see, Shivani, they don't have these. And this, Hawk Warrior, this is what we call credentials. Where are yours? Hawk and Animal, a little poem just for you all. February 1st in Atlanta, GA, we're going to whoop the Warriors the ravishing way. How about it, bro?
Forget it. When you talk about R&R, you said something, Shivani. You say synonymous. This is synonymous. The most awesome team you've seen in professional wrestling today, right or wrong.
You're awesome.
You're right, Daddy, because the heavy metal's around our waist. So rock and roll, you go on and sing your blues, baby. Because Punky Morton, you get in my face, and I'm going to rip your throat right out. And you'll never sing again. And Road Warriors, you call yourself the Legion of Doom. Well, destruction is what we do, and awesome is our name. So the awesome twosome is coming at you. We're not stopping, Jack, because we are world champions for one reason. Because we're totally, totally awesome. And ain't nobody, not even you, Warriors, or Dream, or Chiquita, can touch these two. Because if you want us, Daddy, we ain't hard to find. And you don't have to look in the yellow pages. Just call Mr. Jones, and you'll know that when we come to town, R&R is here to stay. And rock and roll just went away. Because you know why? Because I'll sing to you, Morton, shot through the heart, and weren't you blamed? Because we give rock and roll a bad name.
Paul Jones and the World Tag Team Champions. More action right after this timeout. Vladimir Petrov against Alan Martin. And just a few minutes ago, Petrov walked into the ring and started the assault on Martin. Before the bell rang, and it took Ivan Koloff to hold him back. The man is vicious. The man wants Nikita Koloff. He wants the superpowers. Oh, that time. Crossing up Alan Martin and coming out with a big sickle. And now picks him up. Back. The fans were chanting Nikita minutes ago. And you know that only serves to make him madder. Suplex. Notice how he hops up quickly. There he is! With the Russian hammer. And then Kenzie. The Russian assassin. So that a battle, and the fans were chanting Nikita, that only made this guy even madder.
This is right, you know, Nikita, that's the road. You've seen the devastation of Vladimir. Now you're going to feel it, because it has just started. Nikita, you failed to answer the challenge of beating Vladimir one-on-one, because you are afraid. You know, I'm talking to Vladimir, and he tell me, Vladimir, say, if I want to kick or slap Nikita or Dusty Rhodes, then I better want to do it while they're unconscious, because he's going to knock them out very quickly. Nikita, you signed for a tag team match because you are afraid of Vladimir. Because of this, we're going to make an example. We're going after your good friend, Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, and every American that steps into the ring is going to be hurt. Just as an example to you and to Nikita. You know, Nikita, you were surprised whenever I brought Vladimir in here. And afraid now that you realize that he is here. But there's another surprise for you, Nikita, and Dusty Rhodes, the big red machine. Nikita, one of the biggest and strongest men in the world. That is right. The Kremlin has given me orders, and they have given me the availability of anything and everything I want. American money, any wrestler that I want to get, I can get. Just like that, Nikita, Dusty Rhodes. So you see, it has just begun. And the end will only come when Russian justice is served upon you, Nikita, and you, Dusty Rhodes, for your poisoning Nikita's mind. Here is a man over 300 pounds, over 6 feet tall, that will not answer to anybody. You talk about no law for you, Nikita. There's not going to be any wrestling career for you.
Ivan Koloff, Vladimir Petrov. Fans, more action right after this timeout. Okay, fans, what's wrong? What's wrong?
I
I saw you out here giving Paul Ellering that videotape Starrcade 86. Yeah, I'll spit in your face. That's exactly right, because I'm daggum mad. For one
thing,
you're a sicko, just like all these people are sickos to want to see a tape of me getting hospitalized, and I'm going to have that thing put to an end. I'm going to go to court. I'm going to get that thing yanked off the market, and I forbid anybody in this country to own that Starrcade videotape, because anybody who would want a tape of something that made my mother cry has to be the worst kind of pervert. Now, then we got that over with, and everybody understands me. Ladies and gentlemen, I introduce to you the greatest six-man combination in wrestling, the baddest man in the world, Big Bubba Rogers, and lover boy Dennis and beautiful Bobby, the Midnight Express.
Man event, the opponents, Denny Brown, the world junior champion, George South, and Bill Mahlke. You know, you're right, Jim Cornette, when you say a great six-man team, but you're really mad. I mean, you're mad.
I'm upset about this thing all across the country, in front of God and everybody on the satellite. People saw me hospitalized, saw me humiliated, and now you're selling a videotape of it. Well, that is nothing but a bunch of garbage. I'm going to have that thing put to a stop, and I'm going to supply you with a Midnight Express greatest hits tape to go in place of that. There will certainly be a million seller all over the country. Right now, you see Denny Brown, Mahlke Mania Strikes, Bill Mahlke, and George South, the man of renown over there on the far end. Well, let me tell you one thing. This is going to be some dinner for my boys right here, because we're gearing up for six-man title matches. We're gearing up for the Night of the Skywalkers with the Midnight Express and Road Warriors coming tonight, Washington, D.C., Thursday night. We're going to be in Los Angeles, California, see all the weirdos out there and all the freaks. My man Big Bubba's got a lot of things going on, still has $100,000 coming to him from Jim Crockett Promotions, and Jim Crockett in particular, old tightwad Moneybags Crockett. And you, Tony Schiavone, I see there's a lot of Boy Scouts in the audience today. Maybe you could go out there and they could teach you how to tie a knot and you could hang yourself.
George South, flat out of the ropes. Gotta count out of that. Ted Cornette. Cornette was really upset about that move. Uh-oh. Here comes Big Bubba.
You see George South in there right now. It takes a good man to beat him, but it don't take him long. And there's a good man in the ring, Big Bubba Rogers, the baddest man in the world. And he's training. He's working out. He is ready for Dusty Rhodes. He's ready to kill the myth of the American Dream. Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, I heard you've been talking about it. On February the 27th, he's going to get his $100,000 once and for all when he gets in that cage with Dusty Rhodes. I can guarantee you that for a fact.
And a chance to prove who is the bunkhouse champion.
The bunkhouse champion has already been decided. He won more money than anybody else in the bunkhouse stampede.
You know that's not right. You know it's number of bunkhouse wins.
So now you're telling me my business. You're telling me what's going on. Look at that. I managed the greatest team in wrestling, the greatest single attraction in wrestling, the greatest combination in wrestling, people doing moves in a ring like they've never been done before, like no other wrestler can do, and you're going to tell me my business.
No, I'm not going to argue with you. Go ahead.
What you're doing is you're stuttering around. Obviously, you get paid by the word because you're spitting and hemming and hawing, and the fact of the matter is you know every word that I'm saying out here is the gospel truth, and right now, Big Bubba Rogers just chucking a little bit of the garbage out the back door in there where beautiful Bobby can take over and take advantage. Go ahead, Tony, talk about the mat. You don't even know what's going on. You don't know your job. You don't know your business. You don't know nothing.
Well, I'm not going to.
You got ugly kids, the whole smear. You are a loser in life, Tony Schiavone. You come out here giving videotapes of people getting injured, getting critically hospitalized. You come out here and give videotapes away and do stuff like that. But when it comes talking about the greatest six-man combination, the greatest three men in professional wrestling, and, of course, I myself am the greatest thing that's ever been seen, then you fall far lacking in the ability to describe our greatness, the magnitude of our supremacy. Look at that backbreaker. George South don't know where he is. He's walking on Weird Street right now.
There's no doubt about it. These three men, we're talking about, you
beautiful Bobby Loverboy Dennis and Big Bubba have taken control of this, but the fact remains there are still three other men who are the six-man champions. So they are the best six-man team.
No, they aren't three other men. What it is Dusty Rhodes' 1987 Funky Like a Monkey Tour and his two trained chimpanzees, the Road Warriors, is following him around. They ain't six-man champions because they won't defend the title against us. They're scared. We're trying to get six-man title matches. If we do, it's going to be something to see any place we get a chance at the six-man title, because we're going to get it. But the fact of the matter is everybody's afraid of us, just like the Midnight Express are the United States Tag Team Champions. Did you know that, Tony?
They are not the United States. Jimmy, I'm not going to stand up here to all these people and lie to these people about that.
Well, you do every other time you're out here. I don't understand, man. They're the United States Tag Team Champions because right here in this ring, we had Ronnie Garvin and Barry Windham. We had Ronnie Garvin down. He was a beaten man. He couldn't get up. A few more seconds, I think there was something funny with the timekeeper. Matter of fact, because a few more seconds and we would have won the thing, but all of a sudden the bell rang, and now Garvin, he's so scared, man, they won't even get in the ring with us. We are the United States Tag Team.
Oh, what a move.
Look at that. Off the top rope, you talk about Knight of the Skywalkers, he can fly 25 feet in the air when he ain't on no scaffold. And look at this. The teamwork is fantastic, brother.
Oh, right to Bubba. What a move.
I think that's all for him.
I think you're right about that.
Monkey Mania has been planted with the Bubba Spike. The most dangerous new maneuver never before attempted by anybody else ever in professional wrestling history.
What a move. And obviously now you have run out of things to say.
Well, no, I haven't run out of things to say at all. As a matter of fact, I bet you people wish I'd run out of things to say, but the fact of the matter is I ain't going to. Yeah, Bobby, tell him where to go. Let me tell you something. I want to direct right now a few comments to those chicken champions, Ronnie Garvin and Barry Windham, the supposed United States Tag Team Champions. Right here you see the U.S. champions. We just ain't got the belts, because the belts are merely possessions. Like I've said before, the title's what's important, and when we beat your brains out in the ring, we got that. Now, Ronnie Garvin, what you are is a guy who comes out here and talks tough, but when it comes time to get in the ring, you're a yellow-faced, dog-faced coward. You won't put the belts up against my men because you know you can't beat them. You know, after what I said about him, Barry Windham got with Ronnie Garvin. He said, "Well, Ronnie, maybe we ought to go ahead and give the Midnight Express a title match, because he's a goof, he's a punk, he's an idiot." And Ronnie Garvin, he grabbed him up by the lapels, he started slapping him back to head and face. He said, "What's the matter with you, punk? Don't you realize as soon as we get in the ring with them, we're going to lose our belts?" Well, Ronnie Garvin, you get in the ring with us, brother, you're going to lose more than your belts. You're going to lose your livelihood, and you're going to lose your career, because I don't like people standing in the way of what we want. And Dusty Rhodes, you and that Jim Crockett, I bet you're real close. I bet you're real good friends. And Jim Crockett knew that he was going to have to deduct a one and a bunch of zeros off his bank account if Big Bubba got the money that was rightfully coming to him. So you got this plan together. Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, the Civic Arena on February the 27th in the cage. You and Big Bubba for the Bunkhouse Championship, and Dusty Rhodes, he's going to make you look like a bowl of coleslaw. And then we're going into the Crockett Cup in April with all that money.
They're just showing Bill Mulkey being helped out as a result of that Bubba spike or whatever it was.
Bill Mulkey needs to be helped out. Bill Mulkey needs some help with his financial, all his medical stuff. He needs a lot of help. Everybody's going to need help that gets with us, brother. I can guarantee you that. We're out of here.
Okay, fans, more action right after this timeout. One part of the Four Horsemen, Arn Anderson against Big Bill Tab. And Arn quickly with a knee and a left hand. That takes Tab down. Member of the Minnesota Wrecking Crew. Member of the Four Horsemen, guided by James J. Dillon. And, you know, talking about the Four Horsemen, we heard James J. Dillon earlier say the Horsemen have no room for expansion at all, and then went up on the apron of the ring, said something to Lex Luger, and Luger would not divulge exactly what that was about. But the fact remains that when you talk about the Horsemen, the Andersons, Tully Blanchard, and Ric Flair, you're talking about an elite group. Holding two world titles, Ric Flair holding the title, the World Heavyweight title, and Tully Blanchard, that prestigious World Television title. So you're talking about traveling in circles. The top team, the championship team. And Arn Anderson, an integral part of that. Stomping down the arm. There's an Anderson trade. He's been working on that arm since the opening moment of the match. Iron wanting Bill Tab to give up, but Tab comes back with the right hands over his own. A reversal. Iron ducks down. Tab over top. Arn Anderson with a spine buster on that big man. Awesome. And a win for Arn Anderson with a spine buster on a big man, Big Bill Tab. And back again with a man who says he wants to be part of the Four Horsemen. And by all evidence in the ring, you can do it in the ring, Lex Luger.
You know, there's a lot of talk out here. Some top wrestlers, so-called fan favorites, denouncing my desire to become a horseman. They've got to talk tough. That's what the fans want to hear. But I didn't get to where I am by dissecting my opponents. You really look at it. If you get your VCRs out at home and freeze frame it, you'll see a big lump forming in their throat. If you look down inside their stomach, it's turning, it's churning. There's butterflies down there, because they're just like all you people out there at home. They've never seen anything like Lex Luger before either. And they say, I may have to step in the ring with this man, and it makes me a little bit nervous. And being a horseman will only elevate me that much further, make me that much more of a dangerous opponent. So all you, heed this. I will be a horseman. You all maybe cause a little bit of sleepless nights. But that's going to happen. You can count on it.
Okay, Lex Luger claiming that he will be a horseman. And, you know, he wouldn't divulge exactly what James J. Dillon said to him up in the ring earlier in our show, but obviously something that they both agreed upon and something that we will obviously find out more about in the weeks to come here on World Championship Wrestling. Well, of course, World Championship Wrestling, our Sunday edition program, is tomorrow night, and it all starts at 5:30 Eastern Time right here on the Superstation. Once again, all the top stars in the world of wrestling will be with you. And don't forget to join us back here next Saturday at 6:05 Eastern for more of the best on World Championship Wrestling. I'm Tony Schiavone, and don't forget, the best wrestling is right here, the NWA. And we'll see you next week for all of us at Jim Crockett Promotions and Turner Broadcast. And I'm Tony Schiavone. See you next week on World Championship Wrestling.